Anyways, this next album is Secret
Jacob's,
Garden.
Jacob's reacting to this album
reacting this live because
forgot
to
listen to
reviewing this.
You forgot it. You forgot Oh My Girl existed. How dare you?
No, I didn't forget it existed. I didn't realize we were reviewing this for some reason.
He missed the messages.
Yeah. Anyways, we will be... I'll be reacting to, and they'll be reviewing, Secret Garden, which is a mini-album from Oh My Girl.
Yep.
Track one is Secret Garden.
Yep. I guess I'll go... I'll explain
it
since you don't know this. So, I mean, this is, like... To me, this is an upbeat Closer. So, like, it's similar to Closer, but it's way more upbeat.
Dude,
Closer with
like one of my
Closer's
favorite
my
songs.
Favorite. Yeah, it is my favorite OMG track single. But this is, and then the strings reminded me of an early IU song.
Although one time I was listening to Closer, and one of the Korean girls was making fun of me because I was listening to Oh My Girl.
Oh my God.
Hey, Oh My Girl's good. What are you talking about?
yeah
no
but
judge.
That's like just in general. All K-pop is like. If you're, really? She'd probably make fun of him for listening to anything that isn't like BTS or Twice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
because he's listening to new groups
but,
that no
wait,
one knows.
You should have watched the music video, Jacob. They had
well,
the
she knew who Oh My Girl was, but yeah,
you should have watched the music video. They had the velvet dresses that you loved so much from.
Oh
the
yeah,
show.
I see that.
Video.
I see that in the album cover.
So like, so this song is good, but I think so. Like, I don't want to sound down on it, but as we get through the album, it's easily like the most generic, and like. Safe song, if that makes sense.
Yeah,
safe is a probably
me,
better
I,
word.
I like this song
safe,
so far.
Safe is probably a better word than generic, because the rest of the album is like so experimental and weird.
Yeah,
and it turns out so good that like
is,
this was easily my least favorite song on the album.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I could see that. Because for me, when it comes to Oh My Girl, pretty much Pink Ocean's my favorite like album from them, and it so far it's just been really hard for them to just sort of match that Pink Ocean's level of, and even with like the repackage with Windy Day in it, like I feel like they did. So yeah, Coloring Book, which is sort of like Liar Liar, which is like a like their like fast like upbeat sort of song, and then Secret.
Yeah.
Then they had Windy Day, which is I guess sort of similar to like Secret Garden, where it's just like a chiller or like slower paced sort of song. And I guess I kind of like the Coloring Books and the Liar Liars more from Oh My Girl than this sort of thing. But
see,
I mean, yeah, it definitely feels safe in a way.
Yeah.
But,
yeah. See, I like Closer like Jacob, but they haven't done Closer. Past
yeah,
Closer,
they haven't even gotten close
but
to that concept
the
anymore.
Album tracks on this are Closer, and that's why I'm like, they should have just made
one thing
other songs the title.
If there's one thing about Oh My Girl, is that it's that I love I love their album tracks like again the going back to Pink Ocean, which is like so excellent.
Mm.
So
okay, Jacob, live reactions.
So yeah, I actually like this song quite
see,
a bit
he's
so
not,
far. From...
He's not biased by listening to the rest of the album, which makes him down on this song.
I'm not down on the song at all. I think it's pretty good.
But,
it reminds me of like G Friend crossed with like
probably
G Friend or
like
early IU
album track,
early IU
like
with the strings.
Yeah,
and
I can
stuff,
see
yeah.
IU too. Yeah, like older IU.
Yep. That's exactly what, so like we sound down on it because the rest of the album is so good, but I think
right,
it's a
well,
good
I'm
song
forward to the following tracks,
it's a good song, it's just it's the most safe and boring song.
Hopefully your hype doesn't kill my score.
Oh no, it won't. Get this next song is like one of my favorite K-pop right. songs in a long time.
So then let's go into song number two, Love O'Clock.
This is like
what
drive
time is it?
For me this
Love
is
Love O'Clock.
This is like a mysterious cosmic vibe, like really similar to Closer, and then like a hardcore rap section comes out of nowhere, and it's amazing. It's
okay,
amazing.
Exactly. This
song like, is so good.
It reminds me of like off the back. It reminds me of something like Gorillaz would come out with.
That's why I said. Because didn't you say that about Drive? I said this is like Drive from Yuna's album. Like it's just this weird, mysterious song, and I love it.
This is probably
like if they had like a featuring like female vocalist or something like that, I could see.
I'm just
like,
waiting for Jacob's face when he gets the rap section.
Anyways, you guys react while I'm listening.
Yeah, this song is probably closer to Windy Day even more than Secret Garden is, because it definitely has this similar sort of vibe to Windy Day. But yeah, this song was great. The rap part, not even getting to the rap part, I love like the instrumentals and like the weird like sort of feel to it. Yeah, this is what I like out of Oh My Girl, definitely.
Yeah. They remind me of like a Cosmic Girl song almost, because it's got
like
cosmic weird vibe to it. And then, yeah, then hardcore rap section goes out of nowhere. And I was like, holy crap. Like, Oh My Girl has actual
they
rappers.
They finally did it. They, like, after so long.
They rapped, and they rapped very well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's definitely an underrated rap line.
Yeah. I honestly think this should have been the title track.
Yeah, I don't know why they couldn't have. Because, again, they had Windy Day before, and Windy Day was a popular song, so... It's not like this couldn't have
done
well. Isn't
that like their most popular song?
No, I think their most popular would still have to be either maybe like Liar Liar or...
Yeah, Liar Liar is probably their most popular.
Yeah.
You got three-yard take up?
No, I'm waiting for it. There's so many build-ups and then they go into singing again.
Oh, see.
You got me anticipating it now. Oh, here it is. What does this sound like? This sounds like something. Wait, who are the rappers in this group?
I don't know. I don't know Oh My Girl's names very well.
Yeah, I'm really bad. The only people
I know
are like Beanie
and Gio.
I only know Beanie and Ara.
Because
Beanie's my bias.
That's true. So I guess I know most of them, but I don't know which ones are rappers.
Who's the girl with the nice teeth? Who's in the middle?
What?
The one with the nice teeth.
All I know is she always has
nice
teeth.
I'm not looking at...
Anyways, this song is, I like this song a lot. Like, it's like a girlier, like, gorilla song to me. And then there's the hardcore rap
girlier
in the middle, like,
gorilla song,
for a girl
Jesus
group
Christ.
Song.
Gorillas is like the least girly song you
no,
can
I
get.
No, I know, but like,
and
this
you're
is
like,
something
this is
that
a
I could,
girly
like, if they,
song.
Like, say if they produced for a girl group, I feel like this is what they'd come up with.
Yeah.
Like, the what they did with, like, the sound effects and stuff like that in the beginning. I don't know. Anyways. Yeah, I really like the song. The vocals were nice. The flow was good. The rap was unexpected, but it was cool.
Yeah, exactly.
I like the song.
Yep.
So, going into the third song, Butterfly.
Yep. So, this is more traditional, like, Oh My Girl acoustic pop song. Like, this one definitely didn't stand out as much. But it has another, like, rap part that is also very good that I didn't expect.
See, like, normally I don't like any of this, like, sort of maybe generic-sounding or safe-sounding group songs, but when it comes to Oh My Girl, it's, like, they're, like, the one exception because I love this sort of style from them. So, yeah, this is Butterfly was actually one of my favorite songs because, again, all the songs off of Pink Ocean sounded like this. So, yeah, this is kind of more in that sort of style.
Yeah, I like this, actually. It sounds to me like something A-Pink would do.
Which is funny, considering I don't like A-Pink that much in comparison.
Blasphemy.
Well, no, I like them. I like them, but I mean, I probably still like more Oh My Girl more
Panda
than
Bong. The Panda Bong, it disapproves.
Yes.
But, yeah, like, I probably sound down for this song. I'm not really down. Like, I like this song, but, like... Love O'Clock being sandwiched by these safer songs just it amplifies how much I like that song, and it makes it seem like I don't like these two songs as much because just Love O'Clock. I just like that.
You love Love O'Clock.
I love Love O'Clock, and I want that like weird, mysterious stuff to happen more often.
Yeah, this song, I think it's pretty good. It reminds me of, like, specifically, I think if Chodong from A-Pink sung this, it would sound really good because her voice is very soft. And, like,
Yeah, she is a very, very girly
so,
voice.
Yeah. Again, now we just do the rap again.
That's probably why the rap stands out so much. If there's one thing I'd sort of knock against Oh My Girl is that a lot of their vocals sound very similar, so that's why, like, whoa, the rap comes out of nowhere.
Yep.
So the next song on the album is 16, which is a cover of the song
of the
by Sammy.
Twice. No, I thought you were gonna say the by the 16 girls, the title track for 16. So this one's like, this is just like a fun song. This is like a really fun nature to it. It's got like the la part, like la 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 part, and then the chorus. Yeah. The chorus is like an anthem, like group chorus.
Reminds
all
me of
singing.
An Imagine Dragons song, actually.
No, for me, it actually reminds me of Red Velvet in a way, because I don't know if you guys can sort of feel that in that, but the instrumentals definitely sort of remind me of Red Velvet. But with the group vocals, that's sort of like what I love from Oh My Girl. That's kind of like their whole. That's kind of like their whole thing. Like in all of their song, all of their like popular songs. Like Liar Liar or Lying or Coloring Book, like there's just like some type of group vocal or something during the chorus. So
Yep. Yeah, this song, I listen to a lot of Imagine Dragons, actually, like, when I'm not listening to K-pop. Mm-hmm. Like, there are three albums.
How dare
you not listen to K-pop, I say as I listen to freaking Western Tropical House.
Anyways.
I don't listen to Western Tropical House.
Yeah, no, this song, especially in the chorus, is so, like, percussion heavy. Yeah. It reminds me of the songs, like, from Imagine Dragons, specifically, I Bet My Life and, like, On Top of the World, stuff like that. It sounds... I really like this, actually. I think this is my favorite so far.
Nodding my head in agreement, as I have no idea what those songs are.
Okay. All right, I'll send them to you. They're really good. Like, even if... you'll like them.
I've heard of Imagine Dragons songs before, and I've liked them, but I just don't know.
Side note, Radioactive is, like, one of my favorite songs of all time.
Radioactive.
Yeah. Anyways.
I do know that song.
Yeah. There's also a good rap in this song as well.
Yeah, like, I just stopped saying it because it came out on every track, except for the title track, which is another thing that bothered me. It's so safe.
Yeah, I feel like and Love O'Clock could have been a title track.
Yeah, I feel like every song on the album, other than Secret Garden, would have been a better title track.
Probably because it actually had probably because of the raps.
Not even because of the raps. Right, just,
if they're better title tracks. If they change title tracks, they have to keep their Velvet Dresses.
Yeah. I'm fine with that.
I'm fine with that. The visuals for the music video of Secret Garden, I don't mind. It's just
I'm just telling their company they have to keep the Velvet Dresses.
Yeah, come on, WM.
Anyways, going on into the next song,
which is another
Magic
crazy song to me. So this is like minimalist electropop with like a really sensual vibe to it, which is like nothing like I'd expect from OMG. It's like very sensual. That's the best way to describe it.
Like that, the bass line is like really like dope on this. If you feel it,
yeah, that song is just like I just did not expect something like that, and it's another like really awesome song.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's another one of my favorites.
I like how minimalist it is. Mm-hmm.
One thing I like immediately is the particle effects that are like the almost like bubbly
sound effects. Boop, boop.
Yeah, I like those a lot.
Yeah, it's this is probably their most like Owl City esque song.
yeah, I can see that.
Oh, breaking pause.
Yeah, like Nate said, it's pretty minimalist. I actually enjoy that fact. I like having a lot of space in my music, like in between like different layers and stuff. Mm-hmm. Especially when I'm using my good headphones. I can take advantage of the soundstage and stuff like that. Even though they don't have a huge soundstage. Anyways, I'm getting into headphone nerd stuff. So let's review this album.
Yep. So for me, like I said, it sounded like I was down on both Secret Garden and Butterfly, but I gave it a 5 out of 6. I think if Secret Garden was better. Yeah, if Secret Garden was an album track or
cover
not even on the
A-Pink song.
It is a cover of an A-Pink song.
Secret Garden.
You missed that one.
Yeah, I missed it.
If it was, just like, I think if it wasn't there or swapped, it would have been a 6. And then I originally actually only gave them a 1 out of 3 for style because I wasn't really a huge fan of the MV either. But I think I'm going to bump it up. Because not because of Velvet Dresses, just because I don't think this is a 7 out of 10. I think it's an 8 out of 10 for me. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I give them 2 out of 3 and then a 1 out of 1. So 8 out of 10 overall.
Mm. Yeah, I gave it the same score because I love Oh My Girl. Like, Oh My Girl is like one of my favorite groups. I have such high expectations for them, and I'm just like, Coloring Book was pretty close to that. But again, it's just like, it seems like it's kind of hard for them to hit like Liar Liar levels again. So maybe they should maybe they should trend towards that sort of style. Yeah. I know
that for title tracks, that is, I definitely agree.
Yeah,
or just go weird as hell and make Love O'Clock your title track.
yeah, because we need more weird groups.
Just to appease me,
but.
So, yeah, I'd probably agree with you guys. 5 out of 6, 2 out of 3, and then 1 out of 1. I really, actually, surprisingly enjoyed a lot of that because I'm not too high on Oh My Girl usually, but, like, yeah, I enjoyed this album a lot.
Yeah, I thought you would.
Yeah, my standouts were Love O'Clock, 16, and Magic, like you guys. So,
same.
Yeah, I think 16 is my favorite one, though. Yeah, so 8 out of 10. I think it's a really solid album.
Unanimous 8 out of 10. Not the shiny one, though. Unfortunately,
no shiny,
we're not getting 4 shinies in a row. But yeah, we're getting seal. We're definitely getting a seal of approval on all these albums. Because if we don't get a seal of approval on Momoland, I quit the podcast.
Yep. Yep. Come on. Come on. Here we go.
Next is Chew with Heart Attack, which is another of Jacob or Andrew's executive decisions.
I can't leave Chew behind. She's my Chew's definitely my bias in of this newest subunit because ears. And also just because I love the song a lot, definitely.
Yeah, and the music video is amazing.
Music video is amazing. It's like